The U.S. Navy wants shipbuilders to provide it with ideas on how to develop and manufacture a fleet of large unmanned surface vessels, LUSV, to create what it calls a ghost fleet. The official request for proposals, RFP, states, "The LUSV will be a high-endurance, reconfigurable ship able to accommodate various payloads for unmanned missions to augment the Navy's manned service force. The ships will also be required to operate on their own, as well as be able to be controlled remotely." The document further stated, "With a large payload capacity, the LUSV will be designed to conduct a variety of warfare operations independently or in conjunction with manned surface combatants. The LUSV will be capable of semi-autonomous or fully autonomous operation, with operators in the loop, controlling remotely, or on the loop, enabled through autonomy." The U.S. Navy requested around $400 million to build two LUSVs. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes U.S. Navy's Large Unmanned Surface Vessels, LUSV, endeavor to create a ghost fleet. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Sometime back, the U.S. Navy's Sea Hunter project had achieved something special. Sea Hunter, which is a medium displacement unmanned surface vehicle, MDUSV, has become the first craft to ever sail from San Diego, California to Pearl Harbor, Hawaii and back without needing any onboard crew. Viewers may note that the round trip is almost 5,200 miles. On January 31, 2019, Leidos, the lead defense contractor for the Sea Hunter project, announced this achievement in a press release. Jerry Fasano, Leidos Defense Group president, said in the press release, "The Sea Hunter program is leading the world in unmanned, fully autonomous naval ship design and production. The recent long-range mission is the first of its kind and demonstrates to the U.S. Navy that autonomy technology is ready to move from the developmental and experimental stages to advanced mission testing. Technology similar to what is used in Sea Hunter will be a base for several new undertakings. The U.S. Navy wants to develop and procure three types of unmanned vehicles in FY 2020 and beyond: large unmanned surface vehicles, LUSVs, medium unmanned surface vehicles, MUSVs, and extra-large unmanned undersea vehicles, XLUUVs. Viewers may note that Pentagon's Strategic Capabilities Office initiated LUSV under Program Overlord. The program aimed at converting commercial fast supply vessels, which are used to service and resupply oil and gas platforms at sea, into an experimental unmanned ship, which could navigate the ocean with or without human help. The U.S. Navy plans to acquire two LUSVs per year in FY 2020 to FY 2024. These will be between 200 feet to 300 feet in length and have a displacement of about 2,000 tons when fully loaded, making the LUSV the largest unmanned ship to date. The demeanor will be like that of a light frigate. LUSV will be low cost, high endurance, and modular. That is, they'll be reconfigurable vessels and will be equipped according to mission requirement. The LUSVs will be packed with sensors of different types. Initially, these are expected to be unarmed, but eventually could be fitted with Mark 41 VLS, Vertical Launch System. The Mark 41 VLS is present in U.S. Navy Arleigh Burke-class destroyers and Ticonderoga-class cruisers. The Mark 41 cells can accommodate many types of weapons. 1. RIM 66 M5, standard SM2, 2MR Block 3B for air defense and anti-ship roll, with a range of 103 miles, or 167 kilometers, at a speed of Mach 3.5. 2. RIM 156A SM2ER Block 4 for anti-aircraft and anti-ship roll, with a range of 115 miles or 185 kilometers, and a speed of Mach 3.5. 3. RIM 161 SM3 for ballistic missile defense, with a range of 435 miles or 700 kilometers, and a speed of Mach 10. It can also be used as an anti-satellite weapon. 4. RIM 162A ESSM for anti-missile roll, with a range of 31 miles or 50 kilometers and a speed of Mach 4. It can be quad-packed in a single Mark 41 cell. 5. RIM 174A standard ERAM or SM6 for anti-air warfare, with a range of 150 miles or 240 kilometers and a speed of Mach 3.5. 6. BGM 109 Tomahawk for land attack. It has a long range of up to 1,550 miles or 2,500 kilometers with subsonic speed. 7. RUM-139A VL ASROC anti-submarine missile with a range of 13 miles or 22 kilometers. So, LUSVs will be multi-weapons platform in the future. The U.S. Navy envisions a ghost fleet consisting of large unmanned surface vehicles, medium unmanned surface vehicles, and extra-large unmanned undersea vehicles. U.S. Navy is still charting out long-term plans on how the ghost fleet could be deployed in the future, and there are a lot of possible use cases. Here are some of them. 1. Scout ghost fleet could potentially gather lots of intelligence regarding threats like enemy warships, sea mines, submarines, as well as land-based assets. This will greatly increase the situational awareness and help in making tactical decisions. Since they're much cheaper to operate and need no crew, these can be deployed extensively. Ghost Fleet could travel ahead of U.S. Navy carrier strike groups looking for various types of threats. 2. Decoy. Large warships like cruisers, destroyers, and aircraft carriers can be targeted by high-speed boats, missile-firing fast attack craft, small submarines, sea mines, and land and air-launched anti-ship missiles. Ghost Fleet could be used as decoys that could shield the more valuable assets. They could emit signals making them look like a proper warship and divert enemies' focus. Also, they can be used to act as a shield in case of eventuality where these vessels would come in between a warship and enemy's missile and torpedoes. 3. Electronic warfare. The unmanned vessels could be equipped with electronic warfare suites. These systems could be used to jam enemy radars and sensors. They could work in conjunction with other platforms to overwhelm adversaries with electronic warfare, giving American forces a major advantage in battle. 4. Weapons carrier. Ghost Fleet will be used to augment the firepower of the U.S. carrier strike groups. Weapons in Ghost Fleet module could be cued by different sensors to strike enemy assets. U.S. Navy carrier strike group have been used to project American military muscle far away from the homeland. No country on the earth possesses this kind of capability. The U.S. Navy alone operates 10 supercarriers, whereas the world together has around 5 carriers, none being supercarrier. Keeping this in view, some countries have been working to develop ways to negate this massive advantage the U.S. possesses. Rivals are developing asymmetric means by which U.S. carrier strike groups could be countered. The most credible threat to U.S. Navy carrier strike group is the anti-ship missile. Some of the most potent are the Russian P-800 Onyx, Caliber, Chinese YJ-12, and Indo-Russian BrahMos. These anti-ship missiles have supersonic speed, giving the US forces little time to react, and these can skim close to the ocean's surface, making them hard to detect due to the Earth's curvature. Russia is also well on the way to deploy hypersonic missiles, which will be even faster and move at speeds exceeding Mach 5. It's paramount that US Navy Carrier Strike Group can detect these missiles early, so that these can be intercepted and the launch platform can be destroyed. This is where Ghost Fleet will be crucial, as it will move ahead of the task force and form a protective layer. Once it detects an incoming threat, it will itself, or signal the core warships to, fire interceptors to counter missiles and hurl anti-ship missiles at the enemy's warships, which are launching the missiles. So Ghost Fleet ships could significantly increase anti-air defense and offensive capability of the US carrier battle groups.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.